Please check the link. On December 8th, Chinese and French news services reported that Iran had stopped billing its oil exports in dollars. Americans might never hear this news, as the independence of the U.S. media was destroyed in the 1990s when Rupert Murdoch persuaded the Clinton administration and the Quislings in Congress to allow the U.S. media to be monopolized by a few mega corporations. Iran's oil minister, Gholam Hossein Nazari, declared, "The dollar is an unreliable currency in regards to its devaluation and the loss oil exporters have endured from this trend." Iran has proposed to OPEC that the U.S. dollar no longer be used by any oil exporting countries. As the oil emirates and the Saudis have already decided to reduce their holdings of U.S. dollars, the U.S. might actually find itself having to pay for its energy imports in euros or yen. Venezuela's Chavez, survivor of a U.S.-led coup against him and a likely target of a U.S. assassination attempt, might follow the Iranian lead. Also, Russia's Putin, who is fed up with the U.S. government's efforts to encircle Russia militarily, will be tempted to add Russia's oil exports to the symbolic assault on the dollar. The assault is symbolic because the dollar is not the reserve currency due to oil exports being billed in dollars. It's the other way around. Oil exports are billed in dollars because the dollar is the reserve currency. What is important to the dollar's value and its role as reserve currency is whether foreigners continue to consider dollar-denominated assets sufficiently attractive to absorb the constant flow of red ink from U.S. trade and budget deficits. If Iran and other countries do not want dollars, they can exchange them for other currencies, regardless of the currency in which oil is billed. Indeed, the evidence is that foreigners are not finding dollar-denominated assets sufficiently attractive. The dollar has declined dramatically during the Bush regime, regardless of the fact that oil is billed in dollars. Iran is dropping dollars in response to the dollar's loss of value. This is a market response due to a depreciating currency, not a punitive action by Iran to sink the dollar. Oil bills are only a small part of the problem. Oil Minister Nazari's statement about the loss suffered by oil exporters applies to all exporters of all products. And on a lighter note, folks, an epic drought in Georgia, U.S., threatens the water supply for millions. Florida doesn't have nearly enough water for its expected population boom. The Great Lakes are shrinking. Upstate New York's reservoirs have dropped to record lows. And in the West, the Sierra Nevada snowpack is melting faster each year. Across America, the picture is critically clear. The nation's fresh water supplies can no longer quench its thirst. The government projects that at least 36 states will face water shortages within 5 years because of a combination of rising temperatures, drought, population growth, urban sprawl, waste, and excess. Well, how about the honk requests?
And we must understand that as well.
Honk request number 292, Wild Awake. Could I please get a foghorn or toilet flush for Michael Burgess, the congressional representative for the 26th District? Honk request number 293.
And we're fully committed to their national dignity.
Donut Guard, can I get a honk for the forefathers giving us the Second Amendment and JFK for laying things down very clearly by saying, "Those who make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable." Yes. Ha-ha! Honk request number 294.
We're going to win an historic victory this November.
BS Mechanic, Billy Bob Joe, I'm feeling constipated. Sorry to hear that. Can I have a toilet flush for the 67 traitors, oops, senators, who voted down the Dodd Amendment to strip telecom immunity from pending FISA legislation? Yes, you can. Okay, folks, that's it for now. Please check the link. Bye-bye.
And we're helping him to prepare for this role.
Bye-bye. So long. See you now. Watch your head. Please be all you can be. Be a bushwhacker.
Isn't it amazing how babies just instinctively know when someone is evil